Hi, this is Ryarth, and this is Theophrastus Magnus, our mage Breton character for Living Skyrim 2 mod list for Skyrim Special Edition. And we are about to get started. So, as part of Living Skyrim 2, you get to put some attribute points in, similar to if you were playing Dungeons & Dragons or something of that nature. These affect how your primary stats level up in the game. So, I'm doing a mage character, so I want wisdom and intelligence to be high because they affect our magicka regeneration, magic resistance, and that type of stuff. Actually, put that at 19. Actually, let's do both of those to 18. So, I have a few points left over for other stuff. I believe it's agility. Dexterity. Bunch of mods while we do that. There are 854 mods total in this. Alright, so we're gonna get started here. You can either start off in this prison cell with the alternate start.
Approach, my child, and choose where your new life shall begin.
Or talk to Mara and select one of the many options she has here. Pick things like Warlock's Thrall or Left 4 Dead that really kind of make it really hard to play the game from the start, but we're going to pick
which inn are you a patron of?
And we want the Dead Man's Drink and Followers.
Even the lowest among us can rise to greatness.
So once you pick your option, and it's really dark in here. You sleep in the bed. Alright. So we've ended up here at the Falkreath. The reason we came to Falkreath. No.
Good fighting to you.
Was because we can actually get a quick follower here. He's actually pretty decent. If I can find him.
Nice. Be careful.
Excuse me, sir. I don't normally do this, but, have you got a moment to talk?
Of course I have.
Marvelous. My name is Lucian Flavius. I'm a scientist, philosopher, amateur wizard, and something of a musician, though I suppose that's more of a hobby. I couldn't help noticing that you seem... how can I put this? Well acquainted with the less savory side of Skyrim?
This is an
As a matter of fact, I do. I'm here in Skyrim on an expedition, academic mainly. I find the province simply fascinating. The flora, the fauna, the ruins, both Dwemer and Nordic, the architecture, the politics. Trouble is, I'm really not much of a fighter. I know a few spells and can just about swing a sword, but beyond that, I'm pretty useless in combat. Skyrim's no place for that. Milk drinker like me. Not on my own, anyway. So,
that makes two of us.
I'm for someone to travel with. I suppose what I'm asking is, would you awfully mind if I tag along? I will, of course, compensate you most handsomely for putting up with me. Oh, shall we say 300 septims up front? After that, I'll top you up every time we come across something useful to my research. At your discretion, of course. No obligation. Save that you take me with you, and assist in keeping me alive wherever possible. Oh, splendid. Here's your gold. This is going to be quite the adventure. It's a pleasure to meet you. Bleed on. So
we're gonna turn on real quick in the mod configuration the vitality mode widget so that we get the little symbols down at the bottom that show our hunger, thirst, and that type of stuff. Alright, so one of the first things we get to select is a religion. And we have options here based on our stats and things of that nature. I'm thinking that this one would be nice because and let's look and see what our inventory looks like. Ooh, we have a war axe. Go ahead and equip that because we have no spells yet that I know of. A resist fire necklace. Let's go ahead and put that on. Yep, no spells. But we do have a lockpick. Let's go ahead and check and see. Familiar. And let's see if I can do this reflect yet. I have melee inadequacy. I suck at swinging weapon because I've never seen one in my life. And actually, let's level up too. You'll notice that I have to select one. But, like, for instance, my health was 80, it bounced to 90 and then dropped back down. Those attributes we selected at the beginning are the things that will determine what we're going to do. And so, and because the only spell I have is a conjuration spell, I'll go ahead and do that.
Never been a big fan of Falkry. Too many grades.
And then, real quick, I'll just show you. Skill-wise, for instance, I have one in destruction, but if you get over here to the main combat and sneaking areas, you'll see I'm pretty much just weak sauce across the board, and that's one of the adjustments here. Leveling up in an ability does not change your level, you only level based on finding things, completing quests, and killing stuff. So we're going to be weak sauce for quite some time, and pretty much everything in the wild can one-shot me.
Thing, isn't it?
So we're going to go ahead and save and get about collecting a couple alchemy ingredients on our way over to the carriage, because we don't really want to be in Falkreath. Do want to get to civilization, real civilization, pretty quickly. So, because we got a little bit of gold from our friend here, we're gonna go ahead and hire
the
carriage.
Where do you want to go?
And you'll notice that there are now more choices than usual. And I think if I look down here, I think. Yeah. Riverwood is acceptable.
Climb and back, and we'll be off.
So the taxi service now goes to more places in Skyrim.
You ever met one of them cats? Khajiit, I think they call themselves.
Alright. We came to Riverwood because we still want to do the initial quest with Helgen because
ain't every day we get visitors.
We get the contact with somebody. We can get the stuff from the cave there and get a spell tome and some ropes and stuff that'll help me early game here. Looks like the wolves came into town. See the prettiness on that water, it gets even better the closer you get to it, so. There's also additional buildings all over Skyrim, so this is of the Lake Tower. I didn't know that was called Lake Illanata. Illanalta. Signs are actually legible now. So we're getting close to home in here. Had a scare with a nice wolfhound a little ways back. So you enter Helgen, not as a prisoner,
Miracle of a song, that.
I'm gonna run this way, cause that's the fastest way to get to where I go without having to run through the rest of the town. This is a glorious door. The glorious doors mod put in some nice doors. So we're now in Helgen, the main keep area where we get all the goodies that you normally get. Because you have a helper, you can actually carry more of it. And we also have a little lantern we can turn on and off so that dark stuff doesn't bother us anymore. Really enemy danger, I don't need my spells out. You notice we can eat, that'll take care of our thirst. We had a little bit of yellow thirst there. So we drank and went away. So the same old Helgen you remember, except for there, I think there are four dead bodies this way. But we need all the stuff off of everybody because we can start. We're gonna grab a cabbage for eating later. Thank you. have this rug in my house, the Ragnarok mod pack includes spectacular rugs for Skyrim. I didn't take the bread. Instead of dropping it, I'm gonna go talk to Lucian.
Hello there.
And I'm going to trade.
Sure, I'll carry what I can. I'll be right behind you.
Put on whatever you give him, he'll wear the best stuff out of that. Followers do have a maximum carry weight. Varies from follower follower to follower. We're actually here specifically for this area.
Assist. Sure, I'll.
Alright. Junk as we can get. It's good for us. We are at Lucian's max carry weight right now, so. Hopefully, I get something that I need off of this. Got some pouches, the pouches and belt items help increase our carry weight. Go ahead and open these knobs for rooms. Thought I got a novice hood, yeah. And some boots. So, one of the things that we can do here, inventory-wise, takes our inventory down. I guess I should show you. It's caved in right there. So. Alright, we're outside again. Didn't want to have to make y'all watch me run back through Helgen. We will be back to Helgen many, many more times, as in this version you get to rebuild Helgen, turn it into a city, and that's actually a fairly interesting plot for activities, but we need to go to the very bottom part of Helgen Keep here. Side of the bottom part of Helgen Keep. So over here is Relof, and he's injured. Wants me to go tell the people to rebuild. Same thing with Hadvar. And so I have the option of bringing either one of them into the motion. I cannot save both of them. So just for the record, to either save Hadvar or Relof, can't save both. But I read that Sparks book. Didn't. So to go to the real quick. Spiders are still in here, so let's save. Third one's in there. Oh, I killed both of them first. There are additional ones that drop out of there. So hit a potion real quick. One thing to note, spells persist on dead bodies for a while. So, like for instance, his flame on that body of the Frostbite Spider probably would have killed me. NPCs are really good about walking over the dead bodies over and over again to keep lighting each other on fire. So you just have to be careful about not, particularly with flames, not lighting each other on fire and not dying from each other's spells. Electricity is pretty bad too, but frost appears to be the only one that I haven't experienced that on. But frost has other issues. Low level frost spells freeze the body in place, and then it might block the hallway from the room. So I'm gonna go ahead. Alright, so I'm back at Hadvar. Sure, Hadvar, take one of my very precious healing potions. But only one. to get out of here. So from here
looks
on
like
out,
he's gone for good.
You can play the game exactly.
But
like
I don't think we should stick
version
around to see if he comes back.
With exception of the
closest
to
town
the game
from
Mary's
River. My uncle's
the
blacksmith there.
The other quests,
I'm sure he'd help
so
you out. It's probably best if we split up. Good luck. I wouldn't have made it without your help today.
So we're going to fast travel down to Helgen because we've already collected everything on the way, and then move on from there. Alright, so I suck at smithing, but I do need to make a couple of real quick items here. In fact, probably just one. This big leather backpack. That's a huge amount of carry weight to me, so I'm gonna go ahead and make one of those. Spent most of our gold buying the supplies for it. So, I'll go ahead and equip it real quick, just to show the benefit of the giant backpack. If I can find it. Oh, it's down here. So it adds a carry capacity of 100 points to me, almost doubling my carry capacity from what I naturally can carry.
I suppose it's too much to ask that these bandits will just hand the golden claw over if you ask them.
So I did a bit of trading and collecting junk from Hadvar's cousin's house. We'll get on our way. So it's nighttime, so you can barely see things. But up there, there's a new player home. It's free, but you have to do upgrades to it that cost about 10,000 coins. We'll definitely want it later because it's actually a pretty cool home. The other one. There's another one right there. So, nice little home. Get on the riverwood side of the river. And then just below this rock here, there's another one in a cave down there. Also get. And I don't know whether or not either one of those ones cost any money, or resources, because I haven't tried to acquire them yet. By the hunting brew meadery and get a little bit of wheat before I go into town. These are actually beehives. I think you can harvest them. Yeah. Watch out for mud crabs. They are way too dangerous to me right now. This frog is good. 4 health potions. Skyrim has such lovely weather. Now the weather pack gives you a lot of varying weather conditions. They did kill the giant
indoors.
So you'll notice there's more to Whiterun here.
I'm all ears.
Talk to
well,
this.
Not literally,
lady,
of course. What? Where am I? Where am I? Oh, it's you!
Notice the lightning flashing in her eyes.
I mean, what? No, I've never seen you before. I have no idea who you are. It's not like I've been stalking you or anything. Wait! Don't leave! I'm injured. Yes, injured. You have to take me with you. Otherwise, I might die, and you wouldn't want that on your conscience. Yeah, well, that's because... Okay, fine. If you take me with you, I will make it worth your while. You won't find anyone tougher than me in Skyrim. Not to mention that's good looking. Haha, you are so funny. I'm just being honest. And anyone who says otherwise is clearly jealous. Can you name someone better than me? I didn't think so. Anyway, thanks, I guess. I don't. I thought I would help you out. Well, I was hoping you would kind of keep me company. Look, I know it sounds weird, but it's no fun on my own. You can tell me to leave if you want, but surely you can at least give me a chance. Am I not allowed out on my own now? I had a little too much to drink. So what? I guess I must have passed out. I hope I didn't cause too much trouble. Actually, I'm not really that bothered. Of course I'm alright. Don't start fuzzing over me. I'm more than capable of handling myself. I haven't introduced myself, have I? My name is Sophia, but you probably already knew that. I'm quite well known in Skyrim, although sometimes I'm not sure if it's for the right reasons. I kind of see myself as an adventurer, although it's no fun without anyone to witness my heroic deeds, such as... I'm sure there's probably something. I like to get drunk, kill stuff, and be a nuisance. So, what about you? Well, then it must be your lucky day, as I know Skyrim like the back of my hand. Of course, I have many other talents, so just sure to let me know if you need me.
Real quick, I need to see. That looks up to us. So as you can tell, Sophia
what is, it?
Is
Aw, you're no fun. I never enjoyed a lit.
It's fairly
fine, but don't take advantage of me. At least not in that way.
And says whatever she feels like saying.
Yes, let's go. Do you have something to say? Which song? Oh, I'd love to sing for you. Hero, the hero has a warrior's heart. I tell you, the dragonborn comes. With a voice to bring power and to maintain order. Believe, believe, the dragonborn comes. It's a man to the evil and everyone knows. Beware, beware, the dragonborn comes. For the darkness has passed and the flowers yet grow. You know, the dragonborn comes.
Hold. City's closed with the dragons about.
The king,
official
the king,
business only.
Everybody's
fine.
Resting. I don't know all the words, so I'm making them up. Na 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 da da. Na 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 na. Dovahkiin, Dovahkiin. Na 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 na. So you're off to see the Yawl of Whiterun then?
Sophia's songs are quite possibly the best part about
it. Takes, but we must have more swords for the Imperial soldiers.
You just can't go and order that size on your own. Why don't you start with something like that? And that's your end of the game.
So, the first part of living Skyrim 2 is collecting up followers, because as you saw by my fight with the wolf, I can't survive very long on my own. So, we're going to collect up some followers, and then we'll
come
go
on
do
in.
Stuff.
Just stoke the fire. Take a seat and get the cold out.
So first, we're going to get us a little bit of food, drink. You can order a meal or sleep in a bed without having to go find the innkeeper. I'm a customer, dammit. Makes that possible. Also notice the smoke from candles and torches.
Have you by any chance seen a huge drunk Nord and a filthy little wood elf bastard?
I don't think so.
Blasted! Where are those rotten thieves? Look, these guys have stolen something that is very precious to me, and I need to find them before they drink. Well, before they do anything, they will regret. Yes. Yes, you could. The people here just told me that they have seen the bastards heading out to Whiterun with my precious item. I need to catch them. But I have been warned that one of them, the Nord, is very huge and potentially dangerous. I will approach them on my own if necessary, but it would be so much safer if there were two of us.
Sure, let's
you do
it.
That. Thank you so much.
Save. Alright, so we can go to the quest location that we have. So, real quick, while we're transporting there, followers are ridiculously important because they are your method for not dying. Vilya is an important follower for us because she can have her own followers, so she can have her own followers.
Could you, help us?
Take the bottle. Just take it. That damn thing is cursed. It actually talked to me. Cursed me. Yes, yes. Look, I know it's wrong to steal, but me and my body were so thirsty, and the little lady there had left her luggage almost unattended. We meant no harm, but when we opened the bottle, it started to talk. It cursed us. I've never heard anything so evil before. What if I'm cursed for the rest of my life? You will? Oh, what a relief.
Strawberries. I love strawberries. You have the bottle. Wonderful. Give it to me, please. And now I guess I owe you an explanation. But, first there's something I need to ask. Tell me, have we met before? You seem so familiar.
Oh, I'm well, I guess I should tell you about my mysterious mission now, shouldn't I? I guess you have already figured out that the bottle is kind of special. It's in fact very, very old. I inherited it from my grandmother, who inherited it from her grandmother. Before my grandmother died, she gave me the bottle, together with a mysterious note written by her grandmother. It wasn't easy to understand the note, but this much I know. The bottle contains components related to old Morrowind witchcraft. I cannot believe that the content is evil in any way, though.
Something magic is trapped within the bottle, and it requires a certain kind of knowledge to release what's trapped in there. My great-great-grandmother once told my grandmother that the only place where the content could be released would be here, in Skyrim, or, to be more specific, inside the Eldegleam Sanctuary. Therefore, I decided to bring the bottle to Skyrim and to visit the sanctuary. However, I have now been here for quite some time, and although I've been traveling all over the countryside, I have never been able to find the sanctuary. You don't happen to know where it's located, do you? You think so? Oh, that would be tremendous. Please let me tag along with you. Skyrim is a dangerous place, and it's so much safer to be two than one.
I'm cursed.
We will. I'm so happy for your company. And who knows, maybe I can offer something in return? I may not be a very good alchemist, but I can still make some simple potions. And while searching for the glyph, I've seen quite a few places.
Alright, we're going to pause because she has some minor issues. So, fix them real quick.
There you go. Data back.
Alright, that should change her settings so that she doesn't decide to take off all of her clothes when she needs to water.
At the Solstheim meat houses, we often dance on the tables after a few bottles of meat. I don't think it's common practice here, is it?
Carriages to all the cities in Skyrim. Don't forget us.
Come back.
Where do you want to go? Going straight through, or did you want to stop somewhere along the way? Climb and back, and we'll be off. Morthal.
Alright. We're here in Morthal, and this is Hoth. We just hired him.
Alright.
So now he will follow us wherever we want. He's a tank. We want him because of his ridiculously high carry weight. He can carry 4 or 5 times what the other followers can carry. He also has his own bounty hunting system that allows him to get you bounties. We're actually going to save now that we've got him. Make sure everybody's following us. And he wears his own armor that he's got selected there, so. I think actually we got a request from him. He got a journal quest, so we can use the journal quest to go do his little quest there.
This is nice, isn't it?
Duplicate.
I don't know. Elves kind of smell funny.
All of these advanced followers that I have following me.
You must have missed.
Wouldn't it be nice to just talk a little, you and I?
Every time she says that, she wants to tell us some part about her backstory. Right now, I don't want to hear about her backstory. To be surviving.
Strange.
Checking my crab that half held me. You can see why I believe that Skyrim is a much more dangerous
place. I'm so glad that we're traveling to Elden Sanctuary together. The Skyrim wilderness is so scary when you're all alone.
Straight away to that Elden Sanctuary, absolutely. There's a rhinoceros over there. They're called woolly rhinoceros. And the rhinoceros is... up that mountainside.
Uh-oh. Look over there. You know, the it's a good armor. It's a good, strong weapon.
Greatest sister. Face checking my crowd's never a good idea.
You taste my sword!
You know, there's 101 ways to skin it.
That was a bear trap. So we're gonna go ahead and save before we head in here. Alright, and now inside. Frequencies, definitely.
Uh-oh, look over there. That's a bandit. Can't see if you can find me, Edgar.
That's all you got.
Take your stuff.
Uh-oh, did I regret your mistake?
Radical switch.
Yeah, but I was just wondering.
Have you considered it?
No, you're
a bunch of shit.
How I'm gonna get you.
Short. We really want Hoth to come up here. She's on. You can actually
Yes? Did you want some? Yippee! I love holding people's junk.
Sort by armor class, so that helps as well. Now she's actually. Now you're
mine. Yes, let's go.
Greetings. Whatever you say, boss.
Let's get you some good gear as well. Armor. Field guard armor. That one. Some steel.
All right.
And then real quick, I'm going to pause and then do Vilya because of her issue. And then equip my sparks in the left hand. Check and see what I got here. Stuff out of this cave. Enemy danger. That feels like a pretty good session. We'll go collect the bounty from that particular cave and sell off all of our junk, and then we'll start our way.